Sorry for the wait, guys. Oh, honey, sit wherever you like, okay?
And so we're outside this little boutique jewelry shop, and she promises if I let her go in, she will not buy anything. And she comes out with a 3-carat diamond ring, which means I can't bid on the Gutenberg Bible.
It'll probably go to that farmer jerk in Iowa.
Here you go.
New customer, Julie?
Never saw her before.
We were still in Iowa, I believe.
Hi there. Special today is tuna surprise. There's live tuna in it. That's a surprise.
I'll just have a cup of tea with some rye toast, please.
Oh, you got it.
Oh, may I read it?
Be my guest.
May I help you, ladies?
Oh, you're English.
Yes, transatlantic and transplanted, but not transsexual. English humour.
Tell me, what makes a book rare?
Well, one that is both desirable and scarce, and would have had a profound effect when first published, and possibly continues to be influential. Another factor is, and that's a lovely blue, your scarf matches your eyes.
He's English, all right.
But British Columbia is home these days.
Look, Vera, this is an antique, but look how beautifully preserved that is.
As, may I say, are you.
You mean that to be a compliment, you might want to omit the antique part. I'm just teasing you.
Really, I deserve it. Charles Wickham, your humble servant.
She's Lily. Lily McHenry. She's my landlady.
And this is Vera Todd. She lives in my guest house.
Mr. Wickham?
I think those people want you, Mr. Wickham.
Oh, yes. Charles, please.
I'll be right there.
Okay. Are you here for much longer? Because I could,
Oh, we have lunch.
Yeah, we have to have lunch.
Yes, and then, in that case, may I contact you? That is, if you're not already spoken for.
Oh, no. No, I'm not spoken for. Why don't you take care of those people, and I'll just leave my number here on your table.
Good idea, Lily.
Well, then, permit me to telephone you, Miss McHenry.
Lily will do fine.
Please excuse me, Lily. Here's one of my cards.
Well, leave your number on the table and let's get moving.
Right.
I'm starving.
All right. Oh, he's from Canada, Vancouver.
Yeah, that's what he just told you.
Oh, come on. Well, come on. He has to be an asshole. I'm attracted to him. I should have lied and said I was spoken for.
So, when he calls, don't pick up the phone.
Oh, who am I kidding? He's not gonna call. Hello?
I have fallen for you, Miss McHenry. Instantly and inexplicably. Like Dante with his Beatrice.
Who is this?
Wickham, the book fair?
Oh, where are you?
I'm up in my home with the Canucks.
Well, aren't you the funny one?
I just needed to hear your voice. It felt so natural with you.
Well, that's funny. We haven't spent 1 minute alone together.
Oh, I'd like to be with you right now. Hello? Have I lost you?
It's difficult to be together with you there and me here.
Well, you might just find my Green Rover parked in front of your house one day.
Oh, look. I was married twice, and please don't take it personally, but I tend to pick lousy men.
Oh, I do take it personally. You got me curious now.
What do you mean?
Well, I mean I'd like to find out if I am a lousy pick. So, where and when would Miss McHenry like to be together?
Paris, tomorrow. May I think about it?
You have until my next phone call.
Hello?
Time's up.
Oh, dear. Well, how about here?
And when?
When would you like?
I'll be seeing you, guess when.
He's coming.
When?
Your guess is as good as mine.
That's not positive thinking.
I gotta get new linens. I haven't had new sheets since I moved here.
Now that is positive thinking.
They're for him. I'll be sleeping on the couch.
Now that is, who do you think you're kidding thinking?
Lily, did you say he drove a Green Rover?
It's him, all right.
I think your wish just came true. I'm out of here.
No, wait till...
No, you're on your own, kiddo.
I found you.
Hello, Lily.
Hello, Charles.
You're trying to get me drunk.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Funny how people meet, isn't it? I wonder, had I worn a red scarf, would you have noticed?
Oh, yes. I'd have said the exact same thing. That's a lovely red, your scarf. It matches your eyes. Aren't you impressed? I remember some of the very first words that I spoke to you.
No, I think that's what you say to all the women.
Huh. Touché. At least you're honest.
I'm nervous.
Well, we can't have that in your own home. Come here. Even though I may want to kiss you.
We still have dinner to eat, you know.
I vote for coq au vin for breakfast. I can see why you settled here.
Do you ever think about living in America?
I feel like I do, being so close to the border.
It's a long drive from Vancouver to here, yes?
Worth every penny. I took the coast. Glorious. Certain parts of it remind me of my boyhood home in England. Someday, I must take you there.
I was thinking,
If you want company, I could drive back with you, stay a few days, and rent a car home.
What was the name of that lighthouse we saw?
Point Pinos Lighthouse.
How could I forget that?
It's too bad it was closed.
Yeah. You know, I have a chum, Abbott Harrington. He owns a cabin up the Oregon coast. Maybe we could meet there.
Meet halfway, you mean?
Precisely. With this flotsam, I make thee mine.
Oh, we're married now, are we?
Shut up and kiss me, wench. Lily, I think this is the beginning of a beautiful friendship.
Frankly, my dear, I don't give a damn.
Good, my dear.
Hope to see you soon again, Charles. It was wonderful. Really wonderful.
Well, you run a fine B&B, madam.
Oh, we aim to please, sir. Listen to me. Sir, I've caught your accent like a lovely flu.
But you threw the ring away.
Yeah, it got stinky.
That's Tiffany for you. Oh!
This is just a little token. Open it after I've left. Rather useful.
Are those tears I see?
Just a reflection of yours.
Well, get going, because I don't cry as pretty as you.
Should have stayed on the couch.
Come on, Lily, enjoy the ride. Even if it's a little bumpy, doesn't it feel just a little bit good? Come on, please say yes, because I like him a lot.
I like him a lot, too. But there's something. He said he'd take me to England, but not one word about my visiting him in Vancouver.
Don't you ask questions?
Told you, he's evasive. And he doesn't make it easy. And I don't want to make waves. I'm afraid to ask.
Maybe he's afraid too.
Yeah, of getting caught. Well, I've fallen for a man I don't know.
So what's in the package?
No, I don't know. It's a GPS.
Maybe that's his way of saying, come find me.
Or his way of saying, get lost.
Hello?
Well, I dub thee my Lady Luck. While I was visiting you, one of my rarest books sold online. And the chap never quibbled about the price. That's practically as rare as the book itself.
Maybe we should plan more visits. Charles? Hello?
There are things I want to say to you, Lily. But it's difficult.
I know. There are things I want to ask, say too. Maybe we should let things settle a bit, hmm?
Yes. Probably it'd be wise to do that. I will say I had a wonderful time. And I already miss you. Very much.
That goes double. You better miss Vera too, or she'll be crushed.
Yes. Tell her I haven't forgotten that I owe her a proper chat about the silver screen.
She'll like that.
Oh, and I'll ask my friend about his cabin.
That would be nice, Charles.
Better than nice. Well, sweet dreams, Lily.
You too. Nighty night.
You put a lot of miles on that chair today. Dare I ask?
He's not calling as much.
Oh, down to 10 instead of 20?
And when we spoke yesterday, he said his friend's cabin...
It is not available after all. Abbott never said anything about it being rented. I wouldn't have mentioned it otherwise.
Oh, that's all right. There are other cabins.
And, I'm off to England in a couple of days.
Really? How long will you be gone?
Oh, matter of weeks. Book business, you know. Need to catch up with some friends before they die off. Or myself, for that matter.
Yes, lots of things are dying. A few weeks, you said?
Yep. Give or take.
Hold on. I think I hear Vera calling. Hold on a sec, will you? Oh, dear Charles, I have to go. Vera needs me. Send me a postcard, will you? I've never had one from England.
Ah, righty-ho. I'll try to send one every day.
Oh, one will do fine. Pebble from the coast might be kind of nice, too. Oh, I have to go. Vera's waiting. Safe journey, Charles. Bye-bye.
Hello?
Have you missed me?
Not at all.
Oh, that's a crying shame. Then I'll have to cancel old Abbott's cabin, because it's vacant.
Oh, well, on second thought, maybe I can work up a craving for you. When?
In 200 yards, turn right. Turn right. Turn right! Keep straight on. Another 100 yards. You have reached your destination.
Hello? Hello?
Follow the path by my car.
Thank you.
Are you going to come out from behind a tree and scare me?
Just keep coming. We're almost here.
Am I getting hotter?
I hope so.
Beautiful.
I couldn't agree more. I want to kiss you. Right now.
Well, with you there and me here.
Really good.
It's the relish. Curried sweet pickles.
Oh, that's what it is.
Yeah, spices up the salmon.
It's really good.
You called me Rose in your sleep last night.
Did I?
Twice.
Must be confusing with flowers. Lily. What are you thinking right now?
I'm thinking that we're sort of like sandwiches. A bit crusty on the outside and soft and mysterious inside.
In that case, you are a veritable classic. Cucumber and watercress, with most of the crust trimmed off the buttered bread. What does that make me? A ham, surely. With mustard?
Well, you're definitely not an open-faced one. I see you more like a club sandwich. Lots of layers. It's difficult sometimes not to make waves in a relationship.
Were you a wave maker in yours?
When things felt dead in the water.
Mm-hmm. Still friends with your ex-husband?
With the first one. He's dead. And the second one, he tried to rekindle. Oh, I don't want to talk about them now.
Good Lord. Do you know the time?
No, I don't have a watch.
Time to get moving.
We do, why?
Because I say so. Drink up.
So, what's the surprise?
Well, you remember when we couldn't see your Point Peanuts lighthouse because it was closed?
Yes.
Well, here's mine. There's a ghost story about the Talua lighthouse. The Lady of Midnight. The tower was built towards the end of the 19th century, and it also served as home for the head lighthouse keeper. For years, there have been accounts of strange happenings here. Legend has it that the Lady of Midnight, or Serene as she is known, was the wife of the lighthouse keeper in the 1890s. It's said her young daughter drowned in the local estuary, or logically, ocean. In despair, the mother committed suicide. The young girl's grave is supposedly somewhere around here. And the mother haunts the place.
Didn't they ever find her?
No.
Do you believe in ghosts, Lily?
I don't know. I've never seen one. Oh, maybe you're a ghost.
Maybe.
Why aren't you married, Charles?
I suppose doubts has something to do with him.
Yes. That's why I didn't have children. Too many doubts.
Well, you're sorry about that now?
No. No, I have no regrets at all.
Really? I believe it was Arthur Miller who wrote, "Maybe all one can hope to do is end up with the right regrets." Let's toast to that. To the right regrets.
To the right regrets.
I don't think I can give you what you want, Lily.
I never ask for anything, Charles. What is it you think I want?
Permanence.
A long-distance permanence? I'll give you that. Could be quite nice, visiting each other. You come to Monterey, and I visit you in Vancouver. If I were invited.
So, I know I told you that I have things. But I'm not ready yet.
What does that mean, not ready? For what? Is it that you don't trust me?
Oh, God, no. It's myself I don't trust. I don't want to be another lousy pig.
I'll decide if you're lousy or not.
But I'm getting close, aren't I?
About as close as we are right now. Charles, why don't you invite me to your home?
Oh, God, I feel a wave coming on. Is that what's happening, Lily? You're making your little waves, your tsunamis.
Do you notice that every time I mention visiting you, you change the subject? Or like now, you go all quiet. You think I want permanence. I want the man who called me every day for weeks and weeks and weeks, telling me how much he loved me. Where did that man go? Or is this what you do? You get women to fall in love with you, and then you go not so gently into the night.
Stop that. Listen to me. I have a decision to make, and I have to make it on my own, alone. I'm aware how evasive I must appear to be. But you must know that I love you. I know I'm being a total shit. But please, be patient. Just a little longer. Please, don't let me be another lousy pig.
I don't think I told you how much I like the GPS. I pretend you're my English backseat driver. Please thank Abbott for the use of the cabin. Mm-hmm. Or is that the reflection of my tears I see again?
All right?
Yeah.
that was that. So many unanswered questions.
There are ways to find out.
Ma'am, will that be all? Ma'am, will that be all? Ma'am?
No.
You didn't touch your toast or anything. Something wrong?
Oh, I'm fine, thank you.
Toasties. Uh-huh. Oh, yeah. Right away, thanks. Mr. Wickham, you need to get home right away. It's Rose.
There you go. I've got this. Go.
Rose. It is.
Charles deserves the patience of Job.
I saw Rose. She was playing off her clothes and babbling nonsense. Thank you.